Today's lesson, Problem Solving, Making an Organized List, is the sixth lesson in Topic 3 of 4th Grade Envision. The guiding question for this lesson is, how can I use an organized list to find possible combinations? There is one new vocabulary term for this lesson. Please copy it and its meaning down in Box 1 of your homework sheet. Let's begin with the problem-based interactive learning. Daryl has two pairs of pants and four shirts. Name all of the possible combinations of shirts and pants he can wear together. How many different outfits can he make? Please pause the video and do this now. I'm going to begin by listing my two types of pants. I'm going to say I have tan pants, and I'm going to say I have black pants. My two pairs of pants. Now I'm going to go ahead and list my four shirts. I'm going to say I have a yellow shirt, a red shirt, a green shirt, and a white shirt. So I also need to pair those up with my black pants. Now I need to make my organized list. I'm going to create what's called a diagram tree. I start with one part of my combination, and then I pair that up with one part of the other group that I have. And I draw a line. So I would be pairing up the tan pants with the yellow shirt. Next, I'm going to pair up the tan pants with the next shirt. Now I will pair up those tan pants with the green shirt. Every time I change a shirt, I have a new outfit. Here I have four different outfits. I have tan pants, and a yellow shirt, tan pants, and a red shirt, tan pants, and a green shirt, tan pants, and a white shirt. Those are four different outfits. Now I will do the same thing with the black pants, with the yellow shirt, black pants with the red shirt, black pants with the green shirt, black pants with the white shirt. Now I will go ahead and I will list these. This is called creating a diagram tree. That's what you can do it vertically or horizontally. Now I'm going to write them down in an organized list. I like to abbreviate when I'm creating an organized list. So I'm going to write tan pants, TP stands for tan pants, white shirt. I can just write W. Tan pants, red shirt. Tan pants, green shirt. Tan pants, oops, that R is supposed to be a P. Sorry. Tan pants and a white shirt. Okay, yellow, red, green, white. So I have 1, 2, 3, 4. You can also see that same set of combinations up here with the diagram tree. So here I have an organized list, and up here I have a diagram tree. Now I'm going to do the same thing using my diagram tree. I'm going to create the organized list. Black pants, with a yellow shirt. Black pants with a red shirt. Black pants with a green shirt. and black pants. With a white shirt. Now you will see that I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Another way to do this. A third way would be to multiply the parts of the combination. So if you have two pairs of pants and four shirts, you can multiply 2 times 4 to get the total number of combinations, which is 8. So how many different outfits can I make? You can make 8. So by multiplying, you can get the answer for how many combinations can you make, but it wouldn't answer the part of the directions for naming all the possible combinations. You would need to either create a diagram tree or organized list. Okay, let's look at another one. Guided practice. It costs Cecilia 50 cents admission to enter the aquarium. How many different ways can Cecilia pay the admission using only quarters, dimes, and nickels? For this, I'm going to use a table. And a table is going to help me to create my organized list. In this case, I have 3 categories. And in each category, I would need to have the heading of how many quarters, dimes, and nickels. So here I need to know how to add the coins together and the value of each coin to make the 50 cents. So I'm going to begin. Let's say I'm going to start with quarters. It's 25. 2 dimes, 25, 35, 45. So that's 2. And 1 nickel makes 50. Okay, let's start with another quarter, so that'd be 25. How about if we have no dimes? So we need another 25 using nickels. That would be 5 nickels. 5 nickels is 25, so 25 and 25 is 50. All right, let's try quarters again. 25, what if you do 1 dime? 25, 35, so 35, 45, 50, that's 15 cents. So I need 3 nickels. Okay, so that's using quarters. What if we did not use any quarters and we used just dimes? Let's say if we use 2 dimes, which is 20 cents. So if I have 20 cents, I need 30 more cents to make 50. So then I would need 6 nickels. Okay, if I have no quarters, let's do 1 dime this time. That's 10 cents. So that's 40 cents I need to make. So 40 cents, 40, what times 5 would give me 48? So 8 nickels. So 40, 50. Okay, so let's say, what if I have no quarter. Let's try 3 dimes this time. So 3 dimes would be 30 cents. So I need to make up 20 cents with nickels. So that would be 4. 4 nickels. 20 and 30 is 50. All right, let's try no quarters again. Let's increase the number of dimes. Let's do 4 dimes. 4 dimes is 40 cents, so I need to make up 10 more cents. That would be 2 nickels. So as you can see, I started with quarters, and then I removed all the quarters. What if I just did no quarters? What if I just did all dimes? So that would be 5 dimes. What if I just did all nickels? That would be 10. I could do all quarters, so that would be 0, 0, and then that would be 2. And that's all the possible combinations for using quarters, dimes, and nickels to make 50 cents. So we've practiced using a diagram tree, an organized list, using a table to and a multiplication sentence to come up with all the possible combinations for a set of data. Now it's your turn. Please work on numbers 4, 5, and 6 in box 3 of your homework sheet. And to connect to the concept, what are some other times when an organized list can be helpful? Give 2 examples and don't forget to show the diagram tree or the organized list or the table that you will use to solve those other situations. And if you have any questions or comments, please remember to bring those to class. And that's all for now.